Geophysicist Stefan Burns here with breaking news as it relates to Campi Flegre, Italy's supervolcano located near Naples. Well, right now there is a massive earthquake swarm that's occurring at Campi Flegre, more than 600 plus individual earthquakes in less than a few days, and that number actually increases up to about 1,000 if you look back towards the beginning of February. All that activity, in fact, already sitting on top of a rapid upsurge in earthquake activity since 2021 and even going further back to 2005. So this is the most notable earthquake swarm that's occurred here in more than four decades, going back to 1984, and actually, in fact, at this moment in time, even further back. The last eruption at Campi Flegre was 1538 AD, and we've been in general in a long period of quiescence going all the way back to the 8th century BCE. So before the time of the Romans. So we really don't know what it's like for there to be nonstop continuous volcanic activity at Campi Flegre like has occurred in the past. There are three different historical epochs, epoch 1, 2, and 3 for the past 12,000 years, where explosive type eruptions were occurring basically every 50, 60 years. Things have been very quiet, but now that is changing with all these seismic events related to the uplift that's occurring at Campi Flegre because the underlying magma chamber is filling up at this moment in time. So a lot of people are looking at this very closely, and we're just kind of unsure as to what is going to happen next. It is possible to have seismic activity and these seismic bursts, as they call them, at Campi Flegre. We've had that back in 1982 to 1984, also 1969 to 1972, that did not result in a volcanic event. But now this is the most serious this has been for decades at Campi Flegre, and at some point that period of quiescence will have to end. Is that now? We will explore that all and much more in today's video. Boom shakalaka! Here we have a Plinian type eruption simulation provided by INGV for Campi Flegre. This effectively is a worst case scenario. We hope this does not happen. But this goes to show what could happen based on historic activity at Campi Flegre. Town of Pozzuoli is in this region. It's underneath basically all this lava here that we see, pyroclastic flows and more. The town of Naples is nearby. Mount Vesuvius is there. And this sort of activity is not unusual. Just in the past 12,000 years, there have been three different epochs of volcanic activity at Campi Flegre. We had the first epoch that was from 12,000 to 9,500 years ago, in which there were 34 explosive eruptions, which were spaced out on average about 70 years, followed by a 1,000 year period of quiet and quiescence. But then there was a second epoch of explosive volcanic activity from 8,600 to 8,200 years ago, so about 400 years long, of which there were six explosive eruptions that occurred, each on average about 65 years spaced out from the other. And that epoch was a milder, more moderate epoch. The first one was very explosive. The second one was a little bit milder, both of them being submarine volcanic epochs. But the third epoch was an aerial epoch. So most of these explosions were happening on land, not underwater. That was from 4,800 to 3,800 years ago. There were 16 explosive eruptions, four effusive eruptions, and the average time in between these was about 50 years. And it was in the third epoch that you had the Agnano Monte Spina eruption, in which there were pyroclastic falls going out about 45 kilometers away from the caldera and pyroclastic flows going out about 14 kilometers away. So that's very, very deadly. So imagine things flying down, ash, bombs, everything 45 kilometers away and deadly pyroclastic flows going out 10, 12, 13, 14 kilometers away from the center of that eruption. That's just one of them, right? Epoch one had dozens and dozens of eruptions that could be considered similar to that. Now, we haven't had anything like this for a while. The last eruption is 1538, didn't look anything like this. And so we've been in this low period of activity. And that's what makes this recent rapid increase in earthquakes kind of worrying and troubling, because that's definitely a sign that there's some big push of energy coming up from that magma chamber, and it's getting closer and closer to the surface. So let's look at this data. Here we're on volcanodiscovery.com. I'll put a link to this data in the video description. And we're gonna just zoom through these different time periods here to see the earthquakes at Camp Eiffel Gray. We have our different magnitude scale at the bottom. We only go up to magnitude 3 through 4 for all these. We haven't had any magnitude 4+ earthquakes yet in this swarm. The highest have been magnitude 3.9, but you'll see that there have been a whole bunch of magnitude 3+ earthquakes clustered here just in the past few days. But we go back here to January, we see very few, and then we do start to see an uptick around February 5th or so, but really starting around like the 12th, 13th of February, and then really there, just the 15th, 16th, 17th of February up till today, there's been a massive amount of earthquakes. So let's punch into the 14-day. You can see that much more clearly here. A lot of these low magnitude earthquakes really close to the surface, some at depth, but very few. And we see all these magnitude 3+ earthquakes with these red circles there, and the 2 to 3 magnitude earthquakes there with these more light green circles there. All of them, again, you see very close to the top because our scale here is, this is 5 kilometers down. So this is all in the top 5 kilometers there. And typically, if you have some sort of earthquake related to a volcano, it doesn't have to be that high of magnitude because it's more related to the movement of either magma or fluids causing rock to fracture, opening up new pathways for this to flow. So when you get a bunch of earthquakes, basically causing all that brittle rock to just get blasted apart, open up these channels, that's when you have now magma able to flow up, and then either, you know, it can have some sort of explosive eruption depending on its characteristics, its volatile content, the pressure, water, things of this nature, or maybe it's an effusive eruption where it just kind of spills out like you see in Hawaii. Perhaps nothing happens, right? This could just be a fracturing that is just one stage of a long process that has a conclusion much further out. I mean, for example, we did see a lot of earthquakes here back in April and May of 2024, but of course that's also activity stacked on top of this recent upsurge in earthquake activity. So in general, all this should be looked at very, very closely and should not just be immediately discarded and just, you know, not thought about in terms of any actual serious consequences. Because again, as I laid out with the historic detail, Camp Eiffel Gray is a very active, very eruptive volcano system. We just have happened to be lucky over the past, you could say, 2,800 years or so, but that could be changing right now at this moment in time. Here we have our past 7 days. Look at that earthquake cluster there. It's just starting to kind of taper out, but we've had some magnitude 3s just recently. We've had 11 magnitude 3+ earthquakes since this swarm began, and we'll see if there's a new resurgence here, but let's look at the historic data. And again, thanks to Volcano Discovery, we have our earthquake statistics for Camp Eiffel Gray going back to 1980. Here is that seismic event that occurred 1982 to 1984. So you can put this into context. We see this increase in the earthquakes there. We're looking at magnitude 2+ earthquakes and magnitude 3+ earthquakes. Now, they probably would not have captured a lot of these magnitude 2+ earthquakes because back then the seismic system, their network would not have been as well established, but these magnitude 3s they would have caught. We see that back in 1984 there were 25 of them. Well, let's zoom forward now. We see this uptick in earthquakes really nicely shown with these magnitude 2+ earthquakes, but we also see our 3+ earthquakes going up there. That was 2024, that's the entire 12 months. Here we have 2025, we're not even done with February yet, and we are already about halfway to the values for 2024, which was also around 25 earthquakes. Maybe that's like 26, 27 or so. So again, we've just had 11 in the past few days. Here we see our magnitude 3+ earthquakes going up very quickly in 2025. Our magnitude 2+ earthquakes, about half as well of the number in 2024, but the overall uptrend took off dramatically in 2021. 2020 was also a bit of an outlier, but look at that sudden surge up in earthquakes as compared to what occurred back in 1980 through 1984, then all the way into the turn of the millennium in the 21st century. So something seems to be changing at Camp Eiffel Gray. If you look at the statistics, it does not lie. Now we're looking at a map view for Campi Flegre, and this is from February 5th to the 9th, and we see the earthquakes mostly clustered here in this Solfatara area where there's active hydrothermal activity. You have these fumaroles and you have bubbling mud pits and things. I've been there myself back in 2017. It's a fascinating place. Not sure I want to go there now. But from February 5th to the 9th, there were 99 seismic events that occurred, and we see that they're all almost completely clustered right there. And here we have our same map view for Campi Flegre for February 10th to the 14th, and we see 159 seismic events that have occurred during this time frame. Again, most of them clustered near Solfatara, but also a little bit of a wider distribution at the very end there on the 14th, a little isolated cluster of earthquakes there to the southeast, but we now see that the earthquakes are starting to spread out. So the seismic swarm has now started, but it's still in the very early stages. This next map will really show the seismic explosion. And here we have our latest map for Campi Flegre, going from the 15th of February to today, the 19th of February. And when I loaded up this map, it was registering 676 seismic events, though there's probably a few new ones that have already been added on since then. So we're over 600 seismic events, closing in on 700 for this 5-day time frame. And we see now that they've widened out to encompass more of this overall area of deformation, though they are still most clustered there on Solfatara and that most active area of volcanism that's being expressed at the surface. We see evidence of prior volcanism, like we've discussed, scattered across the land. And underneath this entire area is a large magma chamber that's responsible for the bradyseism that this area experiences, rapid uplift and then subsidence. In fact, that's one of the biggest problems with Campi Flegre is that if there is some sort of volcanic event and you have a large explosion or even a fusion of magma and that chamber then is depleted, well, what happens is there'll be rapid subsidence and everything will then collapse down as far as it can. And so that is why we have all these calderas here throughout Campi Flegre, some of them going back tens of thousands of years, some of them being more recent. But this area is known historically for those sort of geologic dynamics. And so for people living here, even if there wasn't an eruption like that Plinian type, which we saw in that simulation, by God, we hope that's not the case. But even if there's not something like that, you could still have some rapid uplift followed by devastating subsidence, which could be very damaging to a lot of people and perhaps even deadly to the residents of Pozzuoli. And the last earthquake map that we'll look at for Campi Flegre is for the time frame of February 5th to the 19th. So basically the entire duration of the seismic swarm, but only for magnitude 3 plus earthquakes. And we see this magnitude 3.9 there in the Gulf of Pozzuoli. So that's one of the strongest earthquakes that have occurred yet in this swarm. None of them have gone higher than magnitude 3.9, but we see most of them located right there in that area of central volcanism. And so that is also a little bit of a troubling tale because we see Solfatara right there. And in general, they're all right in that area. And the stronger the earthquake, the more energy is released, the larger the rupture and the more fracturing of the rock that's occurring. And we see that they're all fairly close to the surface. Let's look at the 3D view. And here we have our 3D earthquake map for those 11 magnitude 3 plus earthquakes that have occurred over the past few weeks. This is from February 5th to the 19th. We see them here clustered from about 1.5 kilometers down to 2.5 kilometers down. That makes sense. They're not right here close to the surface, just 100 meters or 500 meters down. Though don't forget, a whole bunch of lower magnitude earthquakes are in that zone. These are located closer to the central agent of deformation, which has been identified for Campi Flegre at this moment in time, and that's at about 3.8 kilometers down. So the fact that we're having larger magnitude earthquakes occur just above that zone of central deformation, which is causing all the uplift and bradyseism and all the activity at Campi Flegre, is showing that perhaps something is starting to come up from 3-4 kilometers down, is now only about 1.5 kilometers below the surface in terms of the largest fracture zone. Of course, we have all these other earthquakes occurring there, but that fracture zone is not going to be as open, distributed, wide, let's say as easy for magma or fluids to flow through. And so there was just a research paper released in Nature Communications, which discussed this increasing acceleration of earthquakes uplift, and gas emissions at Camp Eagle Gray since 2005, but really look at the change that occurred around 2020, 2021. And this earthquake swarm that's occurring right now is, you could say, the most significant event stacked on top of this. So this is pretty concerning, definitely something to be aware of. It looks like there's something changing fundamentally with Camp Eagle Gray, but we'll just have to wait and see. Though the authors of that paper also stated that a phreatic eruption is possible at any moment in time. This is a type of like steam explosion, where you have water come into contact with superheated magma or rock and it instantly converts into water vapor, superheated. This is like 1,000 to 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit or 500 to 1,000 degrees Celsius, and then it just massively explodes. That could happen any moment, according to those paper authors. And we also saw that Plinian style eruption that the INGV ran that simulation on. Clearly they're looking at that also with open eyes. And so all that is possible. We also have effusive type eruptions, which are possible, or the period of quiescence that we've been in since basically the 8th century BCE could continue. And that's what we hope for. If we look back to 1538 AD with that most recent eruption, that was about 500 years ago. And so the period of times in between these epochs is 1,000 years of quiet and then 3,500 years of quiet. And then that most recent epoch, Epoch 3, ended around the 8th century BC. So it's been about 2,800 years now of quiet, except for that 1538 eruption. So we're kind of at that point where if this is a regular rhythm of volcanic activity and quiet, we should probably be expecting something to occur at Camp Eagle Gray soon on the geologic timescale, but we just don't know exactly when that's going to be. So thank you all so much for watching. Again, I've been your host, Stefan Burns. I hope you found this information useful. I'm not trying to scare anyone. I'm just looking at this from a very realistic standpoint because we see that the Earth does things like this across time. It's not impossible for these things to occur. Just because people have been living here since basically the advent of Roman civilization, uninterrupted and really unperturbed by Camp Eagle Gray, doesn't mean that's going to be the case going forward. We're seeing big shifts occur at Camp Eagle Gray, and we just don't know how it's going to play out, but it's good to be aware of what is occurring. So that is why I'm presenting this video, and I will keep you up to date every step of the way with what is happening not only at Camp Eagle Gray, but also is happening energetically here on the Earth with the sun, the solar system. So please subscribe if you haven't already. We'd love to see you here. Smash that like button. Wishing you all well, and I'll see you all in a future video.